Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. I'm the RPG chick. Let's see if we want to go back into the bedroom. Found some good books in the library.
The door can be opened easily from the outside. If it was up to me, it would stay open.
Well, you can keep it open. I don't know if we have any use for anything over here. Oh, is this like the flower that is down in the garden?
This flower was given to us by the fairies, just like the love lily down in the garden. I bet they belong together.
It needs a mate. Well, that is its mate.
The beautiful red flower from my room. It's new, just like the love lily in the garden. With a bit of luck, they belong together. Water's the easiest ingredient to find. We have copious amounts of it here.
Not sure why we're pouring water in the bowl, but there you go.
Water's the easiest ingredient to find. I could use the bowl to prepare the medicine in. A spoonful of honey, the green fruit from the metis bush, a red herring, and a little water. Crush and blend until a viscous potion is created. Oh, sounds revolting.
So that's our potion that will tell us what's wrong with us. Alright, let's go back out and talk to our friend Arbor. This isn't a metis bush, right? It doesn't have green fruit, it has red fruit.
No idea what kind of bush this is, but if I learnt one thing in the woods... Hi, Arbor.
Oh, Ivo!
Look, I found a book about woodwork.
Look, I found this book in the library.
Woodcrafts? Why are you showing me that?
I thought it might interest you.
I don't like horror stories.
Horror stories?
Wood that has been clamped into a revolving monstrosity to be whittled down layer by layer to the core? What do you call that then?
That makes sense to me.
Sorry, never looked at it like that.
Branches sawed off. Boards nailed together, wood treated with chemicals, sick stuff.
Listen, Arbor, I need to fix up one of these potions.
If I were ill and needed to make some medicine, then you'd help me with that, wouldn't you?
Ill? You're an elf! Elves don't get ill!
But if I were...
Oh, come on, now tell me, how can I help you?
Do we have a metis bush in the garden here?
Do we have a metis bush in the garden here?
Or that bush over yonder.
But that fruit's red.
And what color do you expect then?
Green.
Green? Are they only green when they're not ripe?
Nah, they're blue then. They're green when the bush senses danger.
Pardon?
Danger.
The metis bush has exceptionally delicious sweet fruit. But if it thinks it's in danger, then they go green and very sour. Call it a defense mechanism.
Ah, and the bush only has red fruit because it has nothing to be afraid of here.
Arr, that's right.
What was that with the metis bush and the green fruit again?
If the bush gets scared, feels threatened or unwell, then its fruit will turn green and sour.
Do you have any idea how I could get my hands on some honey?
Do you know how I could get my hands on some honey?
Try the kitchens?
I prefer not to wander through the castle.
Ah, of course. Someone would tell your mother.
Would that beehive in the tree over there be of any help?
Oh, be careful with that. The bees defend their honey and can give you a nasty sting.
Yeah, we need armor.
Couldn't they be distracted or tricked in some way?
Beekeepers wear protective clothes and use smoke that calms the bees. But I don't have any beekeeper kit here. I just let the bees keep their honey and they pollinate my flowers. That's how we've always done it.
Can you lend me a fishing rod?
I often see you fishing. Could you lend me your rod?
Is it made out of wood?
Of course, if you bring it back in one piece.
Oh, you just keep it in your head. Okay.
What's up?
I was convinced that I would have to make my own fishing rod, or that you'd ask me to collect a variety of mystical items in exchange for it.
Right.
It's only a rod.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Well, everything needs to be complicated, you know.
You'd be surprised at adventure games. There's something else.
There's something else.
I've read up about your patient in a book in the library.
I think I know the name of your patient. It's a love lily.
Don't look particularly loved up.
That's exactly the problem. Love lilies enter into a lifelong partnership with another plant. And if they're separated...
then they let their heads droop. Good theory. But the fairies know their plants. They'd never have given us a love lily without its partner.
They did give us the partner. Just been up in my room, here.
I've got a flower here that could help you with your love lily.
And?
Yes, look, do you know this flower?
Sure does. It's a small one, comparatively. Aww.
You did well, girl.
It would appear so.
You sniveling girl. You all right?
Aww.
No. Yes. I don't know.
Aw, love in the
well
plant kingdom.
Then, I think I've earned myself a little rest now.
Well, I'm the one who did the work. Oops, sorry guys. Huh, what's he smoking? Let's look at the love lily. I said we'll look at the love lily.
Isn't that just lovely? Two plants that have found each other and want to spend the rest of their lives together.
So cute. Anything more to say to Arbor?
You're having a good time, I see.
What can I do for you?
Smoking is unhealthy.
You shouldn't smoke.
Why not?
Doesn't have lungs.
It's not healthy.
No lungs, no problems.
Exactly.
Don't you think it's a bit weird and warped to smoke yourself?
Yeah, I know. I'm terrible. Don't tell no one, though.
Yeah, I've never seen this. I've never played this before, guys. Do you sometimes miss your old life?
Do you sometimes miss your old life and the world out there?
Arr, it's comfortable here, to be sure.
And boring.
Well, if you're bored, then why stay?
Me? Well, I'm the princess. And Mother's scared that something might happen to me out there. And to be honest, she's probably right.
Well, of course something could happen to you. And what's it called when things happen to you? Life. That's what it's called.
Life.
You fall over, you get up, you laugh, you cry, you do daft things. Well, how can one enjoy the sunshine if it never rains?
Very wise. So about the potion.
About the potion?
Art.
Oh, never mind.
There's something else.
Nope, there's nothing else. Farewell, don't do too much.
I have to get on. Don't work too hard.
Art, that I won't.
Don't smoke yourself too much. So we have to make this feel comfortable.
This is a lettuce bush. Only its fruit is red, not green.
No, we have to make it feel endangered.
According to Arbor, the bush's fruit becomes green and sour if it feels afraid or threatened.
Oh, let's yell at it.
This is a Metis bush, only it's...
You know what? Here. Pretty intuitive.
If the bush had a heart, it would have skipped a few beats.
Take the fruit. One ingredient down. Done it.
A green fruit from the Metis bush. If the fruit does indeed grow sour, the greater the shock. A lemon should pale in comparison.
Mm-hmm. How about this honey?
The pipe smoke seems to have calmed them down a bit.
Oh, there you go.
The pipe smoke seems to have calmed them down a bit.
Well, now what? I don't suppose we could use something like this to... Oh. I was going to pour the honey into it, but that'll work, I guess.
The smoke from Arbor's pipe seems to be calming the bees. This is my chance.
Hey now, you all right there?
Sorry, had to do it.
Well, I'm not happy about this destruction of nature. Not unless I get half of that there honey.
Yeah, right.
I don't need any more. The rest is for you.
Oh, that'd be good stuff. But that's enough. The bees need a bit too.
Oh, can we get this spade?
That's Arbor's little spade. He always leaves his stuff all over the garden, which of course drives Mother mad.
We take. I got a bunch of stuff in our little backpack here.
I've collected the honey from the bees in this flower stem. It should be about a spoonful. Arbor's little spade. Mustn't forget to give it back to him. You're having a good time, I see.
What can I do for you?
I borrowed your spade.
I just need to borrow your spade a moment. Is that okay?
Of course. Absence makes the heart grow fonder.
You gonna grow fonder for the spade?
I have to get on.
Arp, that I won't.
Anything else about the bowl?
Mother pours water from various... She did the... Ever since...
Alright. Oh, we can take worms. That's new.
I really shouldn't... It's only earth.
Yeah, for fishing.
I should tell Mother how her daughter... well, she'd be delighted. The worms are happy and fat. The earth in the bonsai pot seems to have done them good. There's only a little water left in the bird bath. Aye, however.
Okay, are we going fishing in this thing?
As suspected, there are red herrings swimming in the pond. They are really saltwater fish that live in the sea. But they always come back to their homeland to breed. They're the only known fish variety that can scale nearly vertical cliffs.
Wow.
Red herrings are fast and slippery. Even elves can't catch them with their bare hands. Red herring.
Alright. Let's attach this.
The worms provide a great lure and should increase my fishing success rate, whatever that is. I always hang one onto the hook before I cast the line out.
Makes sense.
The worms provide a great lure. I always hang one on...
Okay, I guess they're going to auto-attach themselves. Just want to look at random stuff, see if I can... combine anything. So we know that one. No random stuff. Okay. Fish in the pond.
I don't have a clue about fishing, but I'll try my luck.
Fishing skill 0.
Just as I expected. Nothing. On the other hand,
a skill went up.
Somehow I have the feeling that I now know what I'm doing.
Fishing skill has risen to zero? Seriously?
I guess that I can just practice until I'm good enough. At last. Now I can take the red herring off my list.
Risen to one.
A classic red herring, a prize specimen.
Do you have everything we need? Was there one other thing? I gotta mix in water, but that's up in my bedroom.
Hi.
Well, what's up?
What are the potion's ingredients again?
The green fruit of a metis bush,
check.
A spoonful of honey, and a
check.
Red herring.
Check.
You have to put everything into a bowl with a bit of water and pound it until it forms a viscous potion.
Hmm.
Thank you for your help.
That's what I'm here for.
Do you have anything to pound something or something? I don't know if a spade could pound. Or maybe pound it with the stone. Good idea. We might have everything we need to make this. Pretty cool. I can't put in?
I could use the bowl to prepare the medicine in. A spoonful of
honey. Oh, does. I was going to put the worms in there. Never mind.
Thanks for the sacrifice, little fish.
Mm-hmm.
It's a start, but there are still ingredients missing.
Yeah. Okay. Honey?
About one spoon of honey.
And the metis fruit.
Oh, that fruit smells really sour.
Mm. Just imagine how it tastes, huh?
I've nearly done it. Just missing the water. That should be simple enough. Then I'll need to crush and blend everything together.
I already put water in there.
Water's the easiest ingredient to find. We have... That should do it. The medicine book reckoned that it should be a viscous potion.
We need to pound it.
Now I've got all the ingredients. I just need to crush them.
With this stone.
I'm pretty sure that there's never been anything so utterly revolting concocted in the elf burrow ever.
At least it doesn't have vomit in it.
This is some kind of joke.
Mm-hmm. Yay. Revolting potion.
I don't know much, but I do know that I'm not going to drink this potion until I've had another chat to the medicine book about it.
Huh.
I need to know which disease this potion's meant to be good for. Looks as if it's been pre-digested several times.
It's to tell us what disease you have.
I don't know much. I need to know which...
Let's go back and talk to the book.
Well, what's up?
Potion is what's up. It's ready. But you don't seriously expect me to drink that.
The potion's ready, but you don't seriously expect me to drink it, do you?
You must.
Oh, no.
Cheap, I'm so... Yes, I know, but... This, medicine.
They'd be knocking this out of our hands.
Well, and the medicine book here thinks it could be something serious.
She has to drink it, the sour metis fruit, sweet honey, and salty fish. That should give us an answer.
Right, it's a diagnosis potion. Can we perhaps get a second opinion about this?
It's not like I doubt your medical knowledge, but perhaps something other than this revolting cocktail might be better.
We've got everything
if
to make
you
it.
Know what is wrong with you? Drink the medicine. If not, then I'll be glad to carry on talking with you.
Right then, here goes nothing.
Oh, it looks revolting.
It is medicine. It's not supposed to taste nice.
Mm-hmm. Don't puke.
That's right. Down to the last drop.
Not as bad as I was expecting.
Really?
In actual fact, it's quite tasty. I could definitely drink another glass of that.
Congratulations, Ivo. You are pregnant.
What? Spit it out. That's what you get for snooping, Cheep Cheep.
No, that is completely impossible.
Who's the father? Not Nate.
You must be wrong. Surely it's a misdiagnosis.
You are an elf and say that potion is quite tasty. I could definitely drink another glass of that.
Ah.
That's raging hormones talking.
What is it, pickle juice?
I don't have any hormones.
I don't have any hormones.
Cheap, no. No, the book has made a mistake.
I can't be pregnant. I've never... Well...
I cannot be pregnant. I've never stood in the divine water with Nate on Midsummer's Night singing the Song of Life.
Huh.
Why? How do humans do it? They do what?
Elves and humans can have children together, but it's not possible without sex.
You see? We never had sex. At least not to my knowledge.
But the diagnosis is crystal clear.
Does she know what sex is? Let's assume that I am pregnant. There must be some explanation for that.
Let's just pretend that I am pregnant. There must be some explanation, rational or otherwise.
Or, yeah, irrational.
If we discount the possibility that the child was conceived by natural means,
then magical.
Which would certainly appear to be the case here, then that leaves us with just the unconventional conception methods. Did you, perhaps, make some kind of pact with a goblin regarding the child? Child in exchange for gold or a kingdom, for example?
No.
Has a god in the guise of a bull appeared to you in your dreams? Any angels been having a word with you?
Oh, not since breakfast.
No.
Have any stars fallen from the heavens recently?
No, not that I'm aware of.
Then that just leaves magic, or a curse. But unfortunately, that is not my area of expertise.
I wish it was so cheap, but my feeling is that the book is right. I am pregnant.
Cheep Cheep's movements at this point are kind of annoying. Mother must under no circumstances notice anything.
One thing's certain. Mother must never find out about this.
She's gonna find out at some point.
I don't know either. Do you think that my tummy will start to show? Oh.
I must have been cursed.
I'm not sure how, and I'm not sure why, but it would appear that I'm pregnant. And as all other possibilities have been eliminated, then it must be a curse that's responsible. That is fantastic!
What? Fantastic?
No, of course I didn't mean it like that, but just think. Me. Cursed. That sounds like an adventure. Totally obvious what we need to do now. We ask Archmage Alistair. He's the wisest magician in the realm of man, and he's a friend. He'll be able to tell us what it means. Oh, no, you don't. You remember who was meant to be looking after me so that nothing happens to me, don't you?
We have to go to Seastone and consult the Archmage. Only, how are we going to get there? I was just wondering that myself.
Alistair's sure to have the answers. We'll have to track him down in the Mage Tower in Seastone. Only, how are we going to get there? Seastone is days away from here. Oh yeah, saying fly is all well and good. Are you going to teach me quickly then? No, we need a fast mode of transport. And then there's the small matter of the Border Watch. Their longbows can take out a fly's eye at 400 meters. And they will shoot if said fly should dare to set foot in or leave the woodland realm without permission.
Password? You don't know today's password, do you, Cheap?
You don't by any chance know the password that the Border Watch use? Typical. That's exactly the problem. Mother chooses a new password every single day, and there's no way I'll get it out of her. Oh, why don't you know the password? You normally know everything. Hey, know-it-all. Mother's mirror. It knows more than you. It must know the password. If we work as a team, we should be able to cast a little light on the matter, Chi. After all, if it is a curse, then I'm the victim, not the perpetrator. Well, yes, I know that. She'll blame us whatever happens. But it's best for us to have some answers rather than just presenting her the facts, don't you think? Transport and the password. Let's go. Hi.
So, Buck.
Well, what's up?
You were going to tell me something about sex, weren't you? Yeah, tell us about the birds and the bees.
You were interrupted just now, when you were going to tell me about sex.
Ooh la la.
Indeed. Someone is of the opinion that a princess does not need to know about such things.
Oh, come on, tell me.
I could tell you a lot about it, but it would be unwise for me to annoy your parents. They could burn me, or even worse, give me to a public library.
Can you tell me anything about elf pregnancies?
How do elf pregnancies progress?
They are very similar to human pregnancies, only they take a lot longer, about 4 years.
4 years?
You are presumably in the sixth month.
And if I go into the world of humans to talk to the Archmage, the time in the human world passes quicker.
Is it really?
Then your pregnancy will go faster, that's for certain.
Huh.
The consequences are difficult to predict. I am not aware of an elf ever having a child outside of the woodland realm.
Let's hope it doesn't come to that. If everything goes to plan, then I'll be back in a couple of days and we'll know what's happened.
That would be advisable. Pregnancy can play havoc with the body and mind. It does not take a lot of imagination to work out what a turbo pregnancy in the human world would do to an elf.
Thank you for your help.
That's what I'm here for.
Turbo pregnancy. Okay. So I guess when she goes into the human realm, she ages quicker as well.
Hey, Cheap.
I'm sorry for locking you up in the musical box.
I'm really sorry about that business with the musical box, Cheap. I had to find out what was wrong with me. Are we friends again? Good.
What exactly is this sex thing that you were talking about earlier?
This sex that you spoke about. What is it, and why should I not have it? I know that I'm an elf princess. That's exactly the reason I should have something like this. Perhaps even two.
Two what?
Oh, I will find out what you're trying to hide from me.
She really doesn't know what sex is, does she? Sometimes I wish I'd just kept the artifact of divine fate.
Sometimes I wish I'd kept the artifact of divine fate. Well, an object that would make every wish come true. It'd be very handy right now. Yes, I know, too much power for one person. That's why Archmage Alistair and I made arrangements.
So what sort of transport could get us to Seastone quickly?
Think, Cheep Cheep. How can we both get to Seastone without me having to grow wings? You've got an idea?
What's that? A brochure?
A flight magazine? You've taken out a subscription to a flight magazine. Yeah, all right. Page 15. Hippogriff stud Aculeus in the Blue Mountains. The best battle and hunting hippogriffs in Aventasia. A hippogriff. That could carry me. Not a bad idea, Cheep. But the Blue Mountains aren't close. And just look at the price. A pot of gold. Now, where are we meant to get that from?
Mother's study.
Yes, I think you're right. We'll have to think of something.
I wonder if we could get hold of the hippogriff without a pot of gold.
Do you think I could play the princess card and ask the stud to loan us a hippogriff? That'd cost a lot less than a pot of gold. Yeah, you're right. They'd blab to everyone. Bad idea if I want to travel incognito. I'll be back soon, Cheep.
Nothing from the book to say about hippogriffs, I don't think.
There was something to indicate that the book was wrong. But unfortunately, it's very sure, and I know it's right. I'm pregnant, and I don't know how, and I don't know why. I just know that I need to get out of here before Mother finds out. The Archmage and Seastone will know what to do. I wish there was...
What if we could say anything to Arbor about it?
Having a good time, I see.
What can I do for you?
I need a pot of gold. Do you have one?
If I happen to need a pot of gold and you happen to have one, would you be happy to lend it to me?
If I be the Sultan of the Three Deserts and you had juicy grapes, would you feed me?
Okay, seriously, do you have a pot of gold?
Just like you have grapes and be the Sultan.
I'll take that as a no. How exactly does this pregnancy stuff work?
Tell me, you know a bit about nature, don't you? How does this childbearing stuff work exactly?
Oh, don't know. Ask myself the same question. The bees pollinate the flowers. The flower seeds are carried away by the wind and new plants grow. Very simple and easy, that. But elves, humans, and dwarves don't produce nectar. What have you got to offer the bees?
Yeah, and also our children don't grow in the earth. They grow in us.
I know. Isn't it absurd?
Have you ever watched Mother casting a spell on the magic mirror?
Do you know how to cast a spell over a magic mirror?
Do I look like a magician or priest?
Perhaps you saw Mother doing it sometime.
Many times. She tips water from three different vessels into the bowl and then mumbles a bit to herself. Some kind of elf priestess magic nonsense. I don't know nothing about that.
Me neither.
I must leave the elf burrow.
Arbor, I'm going to have to leave the elf burrow for a few days.
Your mother giving you permission?
Not exactly.
Not as such.
She's not going to like that. But one has to do what one has to do. I wish you a good journey.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Arbor. And don't tell anyone I told you.
Oh, you wouldn't dream of it. Just don't you go staying away too long now. You know, time out there runs much quicker than here in the woodland realm.
Of course. In the outside world, we elves age like humans. That's why most elves avoid it like the plague.
Quite right.
I have to get on. Don't work too hard.
Alright, that I won't.
Really sounds like Hagrid. The voice of Hagrid. Alright, so in order to get stuff to... Well, let me... She's gonna have something new to say about this.
An all-knowing mirror. In the current situation, that would be more than useful. The only question is how to cast a spell over the mirror. I've never done that before. There are three symbols on the bottom of the bowl.
There are.
I wonder what they mean. They're the same ones as the columns in the throne room.
We haven't been in the throne room yet.
Each symbol depicts a droplet. Sometimes there's a line underneath it, sometimes above, and here is a circle going through the droplet. Haven't got a clue what they mean. I have seen these symbols once before, up in the throne room, if I'm not mistaken. Each symbol depicts a droplet.
Well, we're going to have to go in the throne room and take a look at how these symbols are arranged and, I guess, duplicate that. So we're going to do that next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And bang, bang, boogie. And don't stop the boogie.